Spacecraft in-orbit refueling technology is rapidly advancing towards real-world implementation. Many may remain skeptical about this, especially given SpaceX's current challenges with Flight 9, which followed two failed launch attempts. How could they possibly be advancing the development of the Starship refueling system at such an astonishing pace? However, the reality could not be more different. Recently, SpaceX unveiled an impressive new component that appears to be an improved iteration of the spacecraft's refueling system. This strongly supports the idea that an in-orbit refueling test could be in the near future. What specific advancements has SpaceX made in this technology? And when can we expect to see this innovative in-space refueling demonstration? Let's discuss more in today's NR Studio episode. Recently, an atypical component of the Starship rocket was observed at Starbase. With a circular steel frame and apparently having a diameter that exceeds that of the existing Starship, this component appears to be an integral part of a newly designed refueling system that is currently being positioned at the production site. The device incorporates a metallic quick disconnect (QD) faceplate, distinguished by two sizable circular structures, likely intended as alignment or locking mechanisms to facilitate secure and precise connection during propellant transfer. This design clearly demonstrates a transition towards separating the liquid oxygen (LEOX) and liquid methane (CH3) connections into separate QD plates, marking an evolution from the previously more integrated configuration. This modular strategy, similar to the modernized orbital launch mount (OLM) currently used for booster version 2, is an example of a comprehensive improvement initiative that encompasses not only the rocket itself, but also the associated ground infrastructure. This observable transformation is anticipated to have profound effects on Starship's orbital refueling capabilities. Most notably, it improves the thermal and structural isolation between the two cryogenic fluids, which exhibits substantial differences in temperature and handling specifications. This difference reduces thermal interference and facilitates the management of evaporation and isolation, which are critical during extended orbital missions. Furthermore, it simplifies mechanical design and maintenance, allowing engineers to precisely tailor each interface to the particular fluid it is handling, rather than accepting the compromises inherent in a unified system. This can improve reliability and safety, especially during autonomous operations in orbit, where quick disconnects must connect and close seamlessly without human supervision. Third, the modular framework facilitates simultaneous development and testing, empowering SpaceX to iteratively improve and optimize the LOX and CH systems independently. Considering all that has been discussed thus far, we are undoubtedly observing indicators that could signify the inaugural in-space refueling test of Starship. And why not consider it? Are you apprehensive that the recent challenges encountered with the Starship upper stage during Flight 7 and the 8th of May impede the program's progress? Such concerns are certainly valid. However, it is important to note that SpaceX has consistently demonstrated an unwavering commitment to advancing its rocket technology. In anticipation of a triumphant Starship Flight 9, SpaceX engineers have been diligently and tirelessly enhancing the Starship 5, 2, and its propulsion systems with optimal upgrades. Should failure be deemed unacceptable, then success must invariably be attained through unwavering diligence. Advancing towards a demonstration flight for the transfer of propellant between two Starships is of paramount significance. It is an essential occurrence anticipated to transpire sometime in 2025, or at the very latest, by the summer of 2026. In late 2024, during internal discussions with SpaceX, NASA consistently underscored the groundbreaking potential of Starship to fundamentally transform commercial spaceflight. Of utmost importance, the agency relies on the vehicle to facilitate humanity return to the moon via the Artemis program. NASA has conferred upon SpaceX a substantial contract valued at $4.05 billion for the development of two crewed Starships, one of which is poised to facilitate humanity's return to the lunar surface for the first time since the Apollo missions. Consequently, NASA initially anticipated that SpaceX would showcase in-space propellant transfer capabilities by early 2025. Nevertheless, the postponement of Artemis 2 has consequently deferred Artemis 3 to 2026, which likely alters the timeline for this demonstration as well. Furthermore, Starship has yet to attain fully stable flight performance, rendering an immediate demonstration unrealistic. Nevertheless, one should not underestimate the significance of SpaceX progression towards this remarkable milestone. The recently observed component at Starbase signifies the initial concrete advance in that endeavor. Thus, when precisely is this momentous test anticipated to occur? Considering space's current trajectory, the earliest feasible timeframe for a Starship-to-Starship refueling demonstration is projected to be late 2025, despite the fact that the requisite hardware could be finalized in merely a month or two. While some may express concerns regarding SpaceX's ability to complete the necessary number of launches within the forthcoming 7 months, I remain steadfast in my belief that they will successfully achieve this goal. SpaceX is currently in the process of manufacturing numerous new rocket components, ensuring that hardware supply will not hinder progress. Regarding regulatory obstacles, especially FAA launch licenses, SpaceX does not harbor significant concerns. The FAA has recently authorized a maximum of 25 Starship launches annually. Significantly, should upcoming flights progress without incident, SpaceX could potentially forego the necessity of obtaining a new license for each launch. This would facilitate a series of expeditious test flights aimed at enhancing reliability and ultimately setting the stage for a groundbreaking and secure fuel transfer demonstration. Now it is time for us to delve deeper into the forthcoming demonstration that has the potential to revolutionize the field of spaceflight upon its eventual realization. Microgravity poses significant challenges to the movement of liquids, necessitating inventive solutions for connecting spacecraft and transferring propellant in orbit, an endeavor unprecedented in history. Various prospective approaches are currently under investigation, including the utilization of pumps and the exploitation of pressure differentials between tanks. The proficient management of liquid methane during the IM-1 and IM-2 missions has yielded significant insights. However, the practical transfer of fuel between two distinct spacecraft remains to be validated through a series of test flights. Currently, SpaceX possesses several potential strategies to consider. The initial method entails the utilization of pumps. The second utilizes the spacecraft's kinetic motion to facilitate the propulsion of the propellant. The third and most straightforward method, likely to gain acceptance, leverages pressure differentials between the two spacecraft to facilitate fuel transfer. Upon demonstration of this capability, a significant subsequent challenge for SpaceX will involve the deployment of a fleet of Starship tankers to facilitate the refueling of the primary Starship in orbit. The execution of these tanker flights necessitates a rapid sequence, thereby demanding a substantial array of Starship prototypes and numerous launch pads to facilitate the launch and landing frequency of the booster stages. Nonetheless, SpaceX possesses ample justification for its confidence in the advancements it has achieved. In conjunction with perfecting liftoff and early stage recovery, the company has already showcased its capability in fuel handling in a space environment during Flight 3 pivotal test, where propellant was successfully transferred from a header tank to the main tank within the same vehicle. Although this differs from the process of transferring fuel between two distinct spacecraft, it nonetheless signifies a fundamental advancement. For successful refueling in space, Starship must satisfy three pivotal conditions: establishing orbital connections, sustaining propellants at cryogenic temperatures, and facilitating fuel transfers between spacecraft. Each of these obstacles must be surmounted to guarantee the success of prolonged missions beyond Earth's orbit. The initial phase is docking. This challenge is arguably the most uncomplicated, considering SpaceX's vast experience with docking procedures at the International Space Station, ISS. The refueling operations of Starships will entail the docking of two substantial spacecraft in orbit, with one serving as the tanker and the other as the depot or mission vehicle. Despite Starship's considerable size advantage over existing spacecraft, the docking procedure is enhanced by SpaceX control over both vessels, facilitating precise alignment and engagement mechanisms. SpaceX established a track record of effectively docking both cargo and crew vehicles to the International Space Station, ISS, serves as a robust basis for these operations. The subsequent focus pertains to the cooling of propellants. This poses a more complex challenge, especially considering the cryogenic characteristics of the fuels in question. The Starship utilizes liquid oxygen, LOX, and liquid methane, both of which must be maintained at exceptionally low temperatures, 90.2 Kelvin for LOX and 112 Kelvin for methane. Sustaining these temperatures in the vacuum of space, where thermal dissipation is markedly challenging, presents significant difficulties. The potential danger lies in the lack of adequate cooling, which can lead to propellant vaporization, ultimately reducing the mission's fuel reserves. In response to this challenge, SpaceX is investigating passive cooling strategies, including the application of special surface coatings and strategic orientation of the spacecraft to reduce solar heating. Additionally, NASA investigations into cryogenic fluid management, specifically involving cryocoolers, have yielded significant insights. Cryocoolers are sophisticated cooling systems that can prevent vaporization by ensuring that the propellant is maintained at a stable, ultra-cold temperature, a capability demonstrated in applications such as MRI machines and deep space missions. Finally, moving propellant in microgravity presents significant challenges. On Earth, gravity inherently separates liquids from gases in tanks. However, in the absence of gravity in space, propellants tend to float freely, complicating the transfer process. To mitigate this problem, techniques such as all-edge thrusters are used. These small thrusters provide a gentle acceleration, directing the liquid fuel to the bottom of the tank for efficient extraction. An alternative method being considered involves cooling the receiving tank, thereby creating a pressure difference that facilitates the transfer of propellant from one tank to the other. NASA has effectively used techniques that have been rigorously validated through ground-based experiments and some in space, exemplified by missions such as the RRM-3 robotic refueling mission. NASA's extensive historical and ongoing investigations into cryogenic propellant management form the basis of our contemporary knowledge of this technology. The RRM-3 mission, conducted in 2018 to the International Space Station, expertly demonstrated the feasibility of long-term cryogenic storage. However, a hardware failure prevented a demonstration of methane transfer in orbit. Nonetheless, the mission confirmed important principles necessary for orbital refueling, such as zero-boil storage, suggesting that, with continued development, this technology has promise for future missions. In short, while the technical challenges associated with orbital refueling are significant, they are not impossible. Through SpaceX methodology, the rocket leverages well-established techniques while increasing the sophistication of spaceflight operations. However, questions continue to be raised about the number of tanker flights required for SpaceX Starship missions. Estimates vary widely, ranging from as few as 5 flights to upwards of 20 or more. These variations arise from a variety of factors, including the payload capacity of each tanker, the mass of the lunar Starship, and specific mission parameters, such as the amount of cargo transported to the moon or stored on its surface. While exact numbers are uncertain, it is clear that the success of this strategy depends largely on SpaceX's capacity to execute these flights with efficiency and reliability. In the case of only 5 tanker flights being required, the refueling process appears uncomplicated and feasible, even with recent technological advances. This scaled-down number assumes optimal efficiency in payload transport and propellant consumption, a scenario that could be realized if the Starship design meets or exceeds anticipated standards. However, in more conservative projections, which suggest as many as 20 flights may be required, the complexity of the challenge increases dramatically. Executing 20 tanker flights within a tight mission timeframe requires extraordinary operational proficiency and reliability from SpaceX. Each additional flight introduces an increased potential for delay or failure, which could seriously compromise the overall mission. Despite these challenges, SpaceX's approach to rapid reusability aims to mitigate the risks associated with increasing the frequency of tanker flights. Starship and its Super Heavy booster are engineered with rapid turnaround times as a primary goal, with the expectation of achieving a much higher reusability rate than existing space vehicles. If SpaceX succeeds in its goal of launching and landing the same Starship multiple times in a matter of days or even hours, the logistical challenges associated with multiple tanker flights will become much more feasible. For example, in a situation that calls for 20 flights, SpaceX's innovative approach to rapid reusability could facilitate launches at intervals of just a few days, substantially reducing the duration and costs associated with each mission. Furthermore, the economic framework of SpaceX reusable launch system is carefully engineered to facilitate frequent launches without corresponding increases in cost. A key advantage of this methodology lies in the fact that propellant costs, already relatively low, do not increase substantially with flight frequency. Instead, attention is directed to optimizing launch operations, an area in which SpaceX has demonstrated significant expertise through its Falcon 9 program. The ability to launch multiple Starship flights in rapid succession could make a large number of tanker flights not only technically feasible, but also financially viable. That's it for today's episode. See you in the next episode, and thank you for your support.